And welcome everybody to our last installment of session 7. We're making a triangle calculator for the SSA case. And those of you Algebra 2 teachers out there, you know this is the ambiguous case where we can possibly have two triangles created. Now, to get this thing started, we're going to enter some values again, define some numbers in GeoGebra that the user can input later on. So they're going to give us one side. Let's start off with a 6-unit long side. They're going to enter a second side. Let's make that one 5.4. And they're going to enter the angle that's going to be across from that second side. So this is going to be angle 2, and I'm going to define that to be a 35-degree angle to start with. Let's give the user some input boxes. So the first one, they're going to enter side 1. And that will link to our side 1 variable. They're going to enter side 2, which will link to our side 2 variable. And they will enter angle 2, which links to our angle 2 variable. And I'm going to go to my move arrow, and I'm just going to, we've done this quite a bit so far. Under properties for the input box, change the length to 4. We don't want to take up the whole screen with those boxes. Alright, and let's just go ahead and position those kind of following our template. And we can probably start to color code now if we want to. Any color coding we do along the way is going to make it easier in the long run to determine what objects are going where in our drawing. So let's make our side 1. That'll be our red side. We'll make the side angle pairing at 2. We'll make that our blue one. And that'll just help us get started. Now, we need an anchor point to start this whole drawing, and normally I start at the origin at 0, 0, but I'm gonna make my anchor points I'm gonna make that be the point 1, -1. You'll see why in just a second. I need to make a horizontal line here, and it's just helpful to have that away from the axis. Well, let's create this line. I want it to be parallel. It's going through point A, and it is parallel to the x-axis. Next, I want to make a segment with a fixed length from point A. This is that side 1 the user enters. And then I want to create an angle with a given side, reflect that point B so that it's rotated using the angle 2 measurement. Remember, leave that degree symbol there, that's important. Okay. Now I'm going to right click, I'm going to hide the label on the angle, and we said that angle 2, that's in blue, even rhymes. And then I accidentally plotted point C, so we'll delete that so we can continue. I'm going to go ahead and construct a segment between A and B prime. That is one side of the triangle, and it is side 1, so I'm going to color it red and give it a thickness of 5 so it stands out on the screen. Now, I'm going to go back to segment with a fixed length. This one's going to be spun from point B prime, and it's going to have our side 2 length. I'm going to hit OK, and it plots that. Now, this, we're looking for where this side swings through and connects with that horizontal line. That's what's going to create our triangle. And to show that swinging, wherever that intersection happens, I'm going to plot a circle centered at B prime with that length of side 2. Okay. And now just to make this stand out a little bit better, you can see as it swings through, it's going to make one intersection there and another here. We've got our ambiguous case happening. Let's just change side 2 to be like 5.1. Maybe even bring it down to like a length of 4, just so those intersections are making two clearly defined triangles. All right, well, the next thing that I want to do is actually plot those points of intersection. So under the point menu, I'm going to intersect two objects. I'm going to choose this point where the circle meets our horizontal line we drew in. And that's all I'm going to put for now. I use the segment tool to connect the point B prime to point D, that intersection I just made. And then let's hide some objects. I don't need to see this given length that I set earlier, so I'm going to not show the label and not show the object. I don't need to see point C. And really, I don't need to see this horizontal line anymore. I don't need to see point B. And I also hid the segment. It was overlapping the horizontal line, that first segment with a fixed length that we made. Okay, you can see the vertices of our first triangle have formed. I'm going to go ahead and draw in that third side. And let's go ahead and do some formatting, some of our color coding here. That side that I selected over here from B prime to D, give that a thickness of 5. It's across from our blue angle. Let's make that our blue side. Okay, and then this along the bottom, the only color we haven't used that we have been using along the way has been green. So I'm going to make that green with a thickness of 5 as well. And now we're ready to start configuring outputs of just our first triangle. So I need to measure a couple angles and also measure that green side length as well. So let's go to angle, and I'm just going to select the two sides. Remember, it's always going to go counterclockwise when it measures the angle. So I'm going to click red, then blue. I don't want to show the label on the angle there. And then let's measure the angle from blue to green. Again, I don't want to show the label there. And this angle, the one at the top, it automatically made it green, so I'm just going to leave that, but this one is across from the red side. We'll make it red. So let's make our text outputs. Angle 1, or our red angle, that is this, it looks like a Y, so I'm going to go to Objects, Y, it's some Greek letter, I called it Epsilon, I don't think that's correct, but I should know more about Greek, the Greek alphabet than I do, but I can tell from my color coding and from my algebra window that's the angle I'm talking about. It is the red angle on the screen, so I'm going to make that text red. And I'm going to go ahead and fix that object, the text box there, and I'm going to give it absolute position as well. Now we've got a couple green measurements happening that I need to output here. So side 3, the green side, and I can see from the algebra window, that's segment G. So I include that dynamic object in my text box. So I fix it, give it absolute position, and make that green to correspond with the drawing. And then the last one, angle 3. That corresponds with angle beta. Fix it, absolute position, and then object properties, make that one green as well, so it corresponds with our drawing. So the first triangle's made, but I can see that this side, this blue side, it could swing through, and it's keeping its fixed length. It could create another triangle right here. So now let's construct that. I'm going to go back to intersect two objects, where the circle meets that green segment. And let's connect our top vertex. It was point B prime. I accidentally hid the label for that. Connect it to point E, and here I have another side. And you can see it's still the same blue side that's creating this second triangle here. So maybe I want to keep that color coding. Let's make it blue, and then under style, we'll make it have a thickness of 5. Let's make this a dashed line. So it's just showing that it's a second triangle, and I'll be able to tell the difference. When I pull that measurement out. All right, in creating that second triangle, there's a new segment from A to E. I'm going to want to measure that one in terms of length. So I'm going to go to Object Properties for segment I that I just drew when I connected those two points. I'm going to make this one have a thickness of 5 as well. For a color, I'm going to choose a darker green, one that's going to stand out, and then make it dashed as well. So we can see that that second segment is happening and where it's overlapping. All right, we need to measure some angles. First, from red to our blue dashed side. I'm going to hide the label there. And then I want this angle, it's still green, but I want to change the properties of it so I know it matches up with that dashed side. So I'm going to make that a darker green, and I'm going to make the opacity a little bit darker so I can see that happening and distinguish it from the big angle. I can also increase the size a little bit to make it stand out so I can still see the other angle happening behind it. That's a nice little feature. All right, we've got one more angle to measure. That's from blue dash to, I'm going to make it go to segment I down here because I only want that to show up when segment I is constructed. Okay, I'm going to hide the label there. And this is our second red angle. It's still across from the red side. So I'm going to go to Object Properties, make that one red. And again, I want it to stand out a little bit more, so I'm going to increase the opacity. And I'm also going to increase the size. Maybe not that much. All right. The circle that I used to construct these triangles, I don't need to see that. So in my algebra window, I'm just going to hit the little blue button when it's visible. I'm going to uncheck that to hide the circle. And all the points that I've got visible here, A, B, D, and E, I'm going to click on one, and I'm going to hold Control to select all the others there. Make sure you click the arrow tool first. I'm going to select those, right-click, I'm going to uncheck the Show Label option, and I'm going to have to go back and do that to B. You can see that make that label show up again. So select those points, and I'm going to right-click and go to Object Properties. I'm just going to change those to have a color of black. So we've got a pretty nice view. Our ambiguous case is happening. The only thing that's left, we need to have the outputs for the second triangle, the one made by the dashed segments here. So let's go make some text to output that. What is new? Well, side one, side two, and angle two stay the same. I need new outputs for angle one. I'm going to call this angle one underscore two. And you can see it calls that angle 1 sub 2, or maybe I want to call that sub B. Right. And the object there, that's angle, I think this is really an epsilon, I really don't know, but it's at 120.64, I can tell from the algebra window. Okay. Put that over here, make that red. I'm going to fix it and give it absolute position. Okay. Then, next text, I've got side 3, sub B, and the object that's associated with is segment I. It absolute position, object properties. I'm going to make this that dark green, and it almost looks like black. Maybe I'll go one step lighter. enough to distinguish between my initial side three, the light green, but still green enough I can tell when I look at it. And the last one, we've got angle three, sub B. And that comes from this angle in my algebra window. Right there. Fix it. Absolute position. Let's make that same dark green we used for side 3B. I'm going to take an opportunity here to hide my axes. And really, I probably should have tried changing these sides. I'm pretty confident that this is going to work. But let's just run through changing some side lengths and see how that affects our drawing. Make this 7. You can see now my triangle can't even be constructed. Side 2 is just too small. If I make that a 5, now I've got two triangles happening. What happens when I make this an 8? Now I just have one triangle. All that second triangle stuff is undefined, and it's not showing up in my drawing. Okay, so this thing's really doing exactly what we want. Let's make this 27. It's adjusting the angles, adjusting the triangles. All my output measurements are changing appropriately. I feel pretty confident in this. It looks really good. So I'm going to change that back to 6, 4, and 35, what we started with, to see those the ambiguous case in action here. Two triangles constructed. And I know everything's working, I'm getting all the information out that I need to. I can go ahead and close the algebra window now. And we've got this thing wrapped up, we can go ahead and save it now. Maybe try scrolling the scroll wheel to zoom in and out, see that text stays, even if I move the picture around, the text stays put. We're in good shape, we're done. And that concludes session 7 on all the different triangle solvers we could make for our Algebra 2 lesson on law of sines, law of cosines.